Welcome again to our Princess Ballerinas class. We're going to continue with this month's theme, which is Cinderella. So let's get started. Today we're going to start by reading the tale of Cinderella. So let's get started. Once upon a time, in a faraway kingdom, there lived a widowed gentleman and his lovely daughter, Ella. Ella was a beautiful girl. She had golden hair, and her eyes were as blue as forget-me-nots. The gentleman was a kind and devoted father, and he gave Ella everything her heart desired. But he felt that she needed a mother, so he married again, choosing for his wife a woman who had two daughters. Their names were Anastasia and Drizella. Sadly, the gentleman soon died. Then the stepmother's true nature was revealed. Only interested in her selfish daughters, she spent every penny on ribbons, laces, and jewelry for them. She gave nothing to Ella. Then the stepmother fired the butlers and maids and made Ella a servant. Soon everyone called her Cinderella, because she got so covered with cinders from cleaning the fireplaces. But Cinderella stayed cheerful, for she had many friends. The old horse and Bruno the dog loved her. The mice loved her too. She protected them from the stepmother's nasty cat, Lucifer. Two of her favorite mice, Gus and Jack, always tried to help her with the housework. Cinderella was kind to everyone, including Lucifer. But Lucifer only took advantage of her kindness. Lucifer liked to get Cinderella into trouble. One morning, he chased Gus under a teacup on Anastasia's breakfast tray. She screamed when she saw Gus and blamed Cinderella. As punishment for playing this joke, the stepmother said to Cinderella, you will wash the windows, scrub the terrace, and sweep the halls, and don't forget the sewing and the laundry. But I just finished, Cinderella started. Then do them again, snapped the evil woman. In another part of the kingdom, the king was growing worried about his son. It's time the prince got married, he told the Grand Duke. I need grandchildren. But sire, said the Grand Duke, he must fall in love first. No buts about it. We'll have a ball. It'll be very romantic. He'll fall in love. But sire, it's not that easy, argued the Grand Duke. It can't fail, the king shouted. We'll have the ball tonight. Send out the invitations. There was great excitement in Cinderella's house when the invitation arrived. By royal command, the stepmother read from the official-looking note. Every girl in the kingdom is invited to a ball in honor of the prince. Why, that means I can go too, said Cinderella. Well, yes, I suppose it does, the stepmother replied with a sly smile. But only if you get all your work done, and only if you have something suitable to wear. Cinderella hoped to fix her old party dress, but Anastasia and Drizella wanted her to help them instead. Cinderella, iron my petticoat. Cinderella, clean my shoes. Cinderella, draw my bath and curl my hair. The stepmother kept her busy too. Clean the chimney, dust the parlor, mend the buttonholes, polish the silver. Cinderella worked all day long. When she finally came back to her little attic room, it was almost time to leave for the ball, and her dress wasn't ready. But her loyal friends the mice had taken care of everything. While Cinderella was working, so were they. Dodging Lucifer's sharp claws, Gus and Jack managed to find ribbons, sashes, ruffles, and bows. The mice sewed them to her party dress. It looked beautiful. But when Drizella and Anastasia saw Cinderella, they shrieked, "You little sneak, that's my sash! And that's my necklace, give them back." The stepmother snatched and grabbed until the dress was in shreds. That's enough, girls, said the stepmother. Come along to the ball. Cinderella ran to the garden. She wept and wept. The old horse, the mice, and Bruno the dog stood by helplessly. Suddenly, a hush fell over the garden, and a cloud of lights began to twinkle and glow around Cinderella's head. Come on, dry those tears, came a gentle voice. Then a small woman appeared in a cloud. You can't go to the ball looking like that. Now where's my magic wand? Magic wand? Gasped Cinderella. Are you your fairy godmother? The woman replied, pulling her magic wand out of thin air. What we need is a pumpkin. Watch this. And she began to sing. As she sang the words, a cloud of sparkles floated across the garden. A pumpkin rose up and swelled into an elegant coach. The mice turned into horses, the old horse became a coachman, and Bruno became a footman. Now off you go, dearie, said the woman. But my dress, said Cinderella. You look lovely, the fairy godmother said absentmindedly. Then she took a second look. Good heavens, you can't go to a ball looking like that. Let's see now. With a wave of her wand, she turned Cinderella's rags into an exquisite gown. On Cinderella's feet were tiny glass slippers. Remember, the fairy godmother said, you must leave the ball at midnight. That's when the spell will be broken and all will be as it was before. When Cinderella arrived at the ball, the prince was yawning with boredom. Drizella and Anastasia had just been introduced to him. Then he caught sight of Cinderella. Ignoring everything around him, the prince walked over to her. He kissed Cinderella's hand and asked her to dance. They swirled off across the ballroom. The prince never left Cinderella's side. They danced every dance together. As everyone watched, the lights dimmed and sweet music floated out into the summer night. Good, said the king, as he watched with a contented smile. Notify me the minute he proposes. I'm going to bed. And then Cinderella heard the clock begin to chime. Oh no, she gasped. It's midnight. I must go. Wait, come back, called the prince. But Cinderella was already running off. Cinderella hurried down the palace steps. Tripping for a moment, she lost one of the glass slippers. But she had no time to pick it up. She slept into the waiting coach. As soon as the coach went through the gates, the magic spell broke, and Cinderella found herself standing by the side of the road, dressed in her old rags. Next to her was a pumpkin, four mice, and a horse, and Bruno the dog. But on her foot, she still wore the glass slipper. The next day, the stepmother told the girls that the Grand Duke was coming to see them. He's searching the kingdom, she said, for the young lady whose foot fits the glass slipper. The king has said that whoever she is, she will marry the prince. Cinderella smiled and left the room humming. Her stepmother, hearing Cinderella humming the very waltz that had played at the ball, became suspicious. She followed Cinderella up to her room and quickly locked the girl inside. Slipping the key into her pocket, the stepmother hurried off to greet the Grand Duke. Gus and Jack had a plan to help Cinderella. While Anastasia and Drizella each tried to squeeze their big feet into the little glass slipper, the two mice sneaked up the back of the stepmother's chair. Carefully, Gus lowered Jack into her pocket, and they got hold of the key. They tugged the heavy key to the stairs and unlocked the door. Cinderella went downstairs to try on the glass slipper. When Cinderella came into the room, the Grand Duke's eyes lit up. Your Grace, she said, may I try on the slipper? The wicked stepmother fumed with anger. She tripped the page boy who was holding the glass slipper. It fell to the ground and broke into 1,000 pieces. The Grand Duke was horrified, but not Cinderella. Don't worry, she said, reaching into her pocket. I have the other one right here. She put on the slipper, and of course it fit perfectly. From that moment on, everything was a dream come true. Cinderella went off to the palace with the happy Grand Duke, and the prince was overjoyed to see her again. And so was the king. She and the prince were soon married. In her happiness, Cinderella didn't forget about her friends. Bruno the dog, the old horse, the birds, Gus and Jack, and other mice, they all moved to the castle with her. Everyone in the kingdom was delighted with the prince's new bride. Cinderella and the prince lived happily ever after. The end.
All right, princesses, let's do our warm-up. To start, we're gonna spread our feet out just a little bit, and we're gonna bring one foot up, and switch, 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 and switch. Keep going, just like that, good job. Keep going. Next, we're gonna take our foot, stick it out in front of us, and roll the ankle. Roll that ankle. And try and do both directions. Now switch and do the other ankle. Other direction. Good. Next we're gonna reach up, 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 up. And down to the floor. Hold that. And roll yourself up. Reach up, 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 up. And down to the floor. Roll up. We're gonna keep our feet in parallel, which means they're side by side. We're gonna bend our knees and go up on our toes. And then we're gonna go bend our knees, up on our toes, down, bend our knees, up on our toes. Do that one more time. Down and up, good. Now we're gonna turn our feet up and now we're in first position. So my heels are together, my toes are apart, and I'm gonna put my hands on my hips now. And we bend and straighten. Good. Keep going. Up on your toes. Now we're going to try and hold it, okay? Up, hold, and come down. And now we're going to hold it one more time. Up, hold. Don't come down yet. Come down. Good. One more time. Up, down. Last time. Up, down. We're gonna go off in the second position now. So our feet are a little wide, weight apart, okay? So we're gonna plie and releve. Plie and releve. Plie and releve. Plie and releve. Good. Now we're gonna do our tendu. So we're gonna point one foot, bring it back to first. Point the other foot. Bring it back to first. When I say tendu, you're gonna switch feet as you go. Ready? Tendu, switch, tendu, switch, tendu, switch, tendu, switch, tendu, switch, tendu, switch, tendu. And last time, switch, tendu. Good, all right. Next, we're gonna warm up our head and our shoulders. We're gonna nod our head yes, all right? Nod your head yes. And now you're gonna shake your head no. And nod your head yes. And shake your head no. Then we're gonna take our head side to side. Good, keep going side to side. Side to side, keep going. Now we're gonna take it in a circle, okay? So circle around. Good, keep going. Other way. Good, now our shoulders, we're gonna take them up and down, keep going. And roll them forward. And roll them back. Well done, princesses. Let's go on to stretching. To start our stretching, we're gonna sit down on the floor. Good, just like that. And you're gonna start in butterfly position. So go ahead and put your feet in butterfly. Good. All right. Now, before we move on to the stretch, how about we choose what color our butterflies are? My butterfly Full hold, 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 pump up, and we're gonna fly this way. And fly the other way. And fly the other way again. And fly this way. And duck! Hold on! Don't come up! All right, butterflies, we're gonna go like this. You're gonna go roll into a small little ball, sit up straight and tall, and look back at the wall, and roll into a small little ball, sit up straight and tall, and look back at the wall. And again, roll into a small little ball. Sit up straight and tall so your back is nice and tall. And look back at the wall. And again, roll into a small little ball. Sit up straight and tall. And look back at the wall. Very nice, princesses. Now we're gonna put one leg in and one leg out. Arms out to the side. This arm goes down. My other arm is going to go up, up, up above my head and stretch. Keep doing that. Good job. Hold that stretch. And come up. Now you're going to reach down and grab that ankle if you can. If you can't grab your ankle, go ahead and grab your calf. And free your back ankle though. Make sure your knee doesn't pop up off the floor. It stays flat down. Good job. And switch your leg. We're going to put this arm under. The other arm is going to go up, up, up till it's above my head. And I'm going to stretch. Hold that. Don't come up yet.
And we're gonna flex one foot, point the other, and that stretch, princesses. You're doing so good. And you're going to come up. And you're going to stretch to the side. Grab that foot. And then you're going to grab the other foot. Up and walk your hands down again, but this time you're going to go down as far as you can. Good. Keep your feet turned out.
Every girl can be.
Hold back.
Any dream can be. Close your eyes and see.
And come up. Good job, princesses. So during one of our earlier classes, we did the cobweb posse, where we pretended that we were Cinderella clearing away all of the dust and cobwebs that she had to do when she lived with her stepmother and stepsisters. Today, we're gonna do that again, but we're gonna add in a step. So, when Cinderella was cleaning, she often loved to skip and dance as she did. So, in between each passe, we're going to do a skip. So you're going to go skip, skip, passe, passe, and skip, skip, passe, passe, all right? And each time we passe, we reach up and dust off and clear away the cobwebs. I'm gonna go in this square that I have because I have enough room. But since you are at home, go ahead and clear away as much space as you can to do this activity. And let's get started. As every princess knows, a good princess knows how to walk up on her tippy toes. So we're gonna do releve walks in a big circle. Again, making sure you have enough space. Okay, so we're gonna put our hands on our hips. We're gonna go up, up, up on our toes. Let me back up so you can see. Up, 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 up on your toes, and you're gonna walk teeny, teeny, tiny steps, okay? I don't wanna see any of this. It's gotta be tiny little steps, one in front of the other, up as high as you can get up on your toes, all right? Are you ready? Let's get started. Find your starting place, hands on your hips, plie, and up on your toes, and you're going to tiptoe walk. Keep going. Good job. Let's pretend as we walk that we are wearing our beautiful ball gowns that our fairy godmothers made for us. Mine's blue, obviously. Keep walking. Tiny steps, remember, tiny steps. No big steps. Keep going. Keep your shoulders back, your back straight, just like a princess. Beautiful work. And come down, give a curtsy, turn around. Now we're gonna go the other way. So hands on your hips, up on your toes, and here we go. Good job. As you go this time, we're going to take our hands through port de bras. So they come up, up, up above our heads, and they open. Down, up, 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 till they're above your head, and open. Still taking very tiny steps, open. Keep going, princesses. You're doing beautiful. Up, 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 and open. Up, 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 and open. This is our last time going around, and I want you to do whatever you want with your arms. So you can up in the group, you can do a port de bras, whatever you want. So here we go, up on your toes, and play with your arms. Now give a curtsy. Beautiful job, princesses. If you princesses remember the waltz step that we went over in one of our previous classes, we're gonna do it again. But this time, instead of just going in a straight line, we're gonna do it in our circle. All right, so I'm gonna back up and demonstrate so that we can review. Start with your hands on your hips. You're gonna step forward, and the back leg brushes forward. As we brush, we bend our supporting knee, which is the knee that we're standing on. And you're gonna step up onto a releve foot, okay? Then you're gonna take two steps forward. One, two. On that step, you're gonna come down, bend the knee, but as you bend the knee, brush.
brush low, high, high, high. Down, brush low, up, brush low, okay? So the way I'm going to say it is I'm going to say brush, up, 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 brush, up, 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 brush, okay? That's how you know what we're gonna do. Brush the foot, bend the knee, up on your toe, up, 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 three steps, brush lower, okay? So I'm gonna start in the corner, put my hands on my hips, make sure you have enough space, and here we go. Brush, up, 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 brush, up, up, up. Good. Make sure you're really getting the difference in the levels, so you're going low and up. Now I'm going to change it. I'm going to say brush, one, two, three, brush, okay? So one, two, three for the steps. Brush, one, two, three, brush. Making sure you get nice and low and then nice and high, okay? Here we go, hands on our hips, and brush, one, two, three, 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 brush. Excellent work, princesses.
So the next and last thing we're gonna do before we work on your choreography is going to be spotting, okay? So this is something that we do when we turn, that way we don't get so dizzy. Because when I'm just turning and I'm not looking and I'm not spotting, I can get very dizzy. So spotting is something that you do to make sure that while you're spinning, you don't get dizzy, okay? And we do that by looking at one thing as we turn to keep our focus. So this is gonna require a little bit of setting up because as you know, when we're here in the studio, I already have a spot up for you so that you can look at it. So if you can't do this by yourself, go ahead and get your mom or your dad to help you out with this. I like to use a sticky note because it's not too big and it's not so distracting that you have to look at several different places and you lose sight of where you're turning. So I like to use a sticky note because it's just about the right size. I'm gonna take my sticky note and put it on my mirror, making sure that it's just at the right level for me. So if your parents are setting this up and or if you're setting this up, remember that you want it at just the right level that I'm not looking down at the sticky note and I'm not looking up. My eyes are directly forward looking at my spot, okay? So go ahead and set that up. Now that you've got that set up, we're gonna move along. I'm gonna demonstrate the turns first, so go ahead and stop and watch. And then I'm gonna count them out and I want you to follow along and do the turns with me. We're gonna try and do 8 turns each direction. So we're gonna do 8 turns to the right and 8 turns to the left, all right? I would not recommend spotting either your phone, your tablet, or your TV, or whatever you're watching this video on, because I might not be in a really good position for you to spot. So again, I really would recommend you putting up a sticky note or a piece of paper or a piece of tape or anything else that you can spot. All right, so here we go. I'm gonna demonstrate the turn. Make sure you're a good distance from your spotting point. To demonstrate, I'm gonna put my hands on my shoulders. My elbows are up, they're not down. To spot, you're going to turn very slowly, keeping your eyes on your spotting point. And then when it gets to the point where you can't turn anymore while keeping your eyes on the sticky note, you're going to whip your head around the other shoulder and find it. From the other shoulder. So you're gonna do that with your eyes, follow with your eyes, keep your eyes on it, eyes on it, eyes on it. Whip the head around and keep going. Good. Okay, so we're gonna do that 8 times each direction, keeping on our flat feet, so we're not going up on releve yet. We're gonna do it on releve, but not right now. So, hands on your shoulders, keep on flat foot. We turn very slowly, okay? 1. 2, 3, 4, 5,
position up on releve. So when I do it this time, I'm going to go up, 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 up onto releve. Very carefully turn in place and spot, okay? This is going to help you start to keep your balance while spotting when you turn, okay? It's a little more difficult, so we're only going to do four turns each direction. I'm starting to the right. Here we go. Hands on your shoulders, up on releve, and turn. Keep your eyes on the sticky notes and spot. Two. Three. Four. Good, come down. All right, now we're gonna go to the left. So, hands on your shoulders, up on releve, turn to the left, stay in place, and spot. One. Two. Three. Four. Come down. Excellent work, princesses. Just to give you an idea of what these should look like once you actually start fully turning your chaînés, do not try this, just watch for the moment. This is what your turns should look like when you've actually started spotting and turning at the same time. All right, so that's what a finished chaîné looks like when you're chaînéing or down the floor while spotting. It helps you keep your balance and it helps make sure that you don't get so dizzy that you fall over when you're done. Excellent work, princesses. We're gonna move on to your choreography. So before we dance the Cinderella dance with the music, we're gonna review the choreography. I'm gonna go all the way through the choreography. We're not gonna teach it bit by bit, and we're not gonna do like a little bit and then a dance and then a little bit and then the dance. We're just gonna go straight through the choreography and then we're gonna rehearse it a few times with the music. So let's get started. Okay, so reviewing the choreography, we're gonna start with our feet in parallel and our arms down low. We take our right arm up like we're painting a wall. So like we're painting the wall, we're gonna bring our arm up, 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 and down, 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 down. Up, 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 down, 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 down. Moving our feet in the first position, we put our hands on our hips. We're going to tendu our foot forward four times on the right foot and then four times on the left foot. So we go tendu and close, tendu and close, tendu and close, tendu and close. Other foot, tendu and close, tendu and close, tendu and close, tendu and close. And then we pick our feet into parallel and we do our passe. So we passe on the right foot and then we passe on the left foot and then we repeat. So we do four passes, switching feet each time. Passe. Down, passe, down, passe, down, passe, down. Moving our feet back to first position, our arms down low, we plie, and releve, arms up high. Bring our arms down as we plie again, and close. Very good. Let's run that with the counts. So, on my count, you start with the arms. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Tendus. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Passe. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And plie. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Good work, princesses. Moving on to the next piece. So we start in first position again. Instead of just doing a tendu, we're going to do a dégagé. So a dégagé, the difference between a tendu and a dégagé is that a dégagé actually comes off the ground. So it's kind of like doing the first part of a tendu, and then you lift your foot up off the ground. So I'm gonna do that to the side so you can see. I tendu, and then I lift my foot off the ground, and it comes back. But that's one swift movement. So it goes dégagé, and dégagé, dégagé, dégagé. Let's do it to the other side. Dégagé. Dégagé, dégagé, dégagé. Our foot is nice and pointed, our leg is nice and straight, it just comes a little bit off the ground, and then back down. So, hands on our hips, we dégagé four times on the right foot, we do these passes, the difference is that we're going to be up, up, up on releve. So we're moving up to releve, and then we passe. Passe down, passe down, passe down, passe down. Come down to first, and plie, releve, and plie, close. Good work. Let's do that for count. So just the second piece, so starting with the baby J's. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And we go passe, so releve. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And plie. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
So going over the last part of the choreography, we're going to go over the waltz step. So demonstrating first so that you can follow along. For the waltz step, we step forward and brush. When we brush, we bend our supporting leg, which is the leg that we're standing on, and our brushed leg is nice and straight with a pointed toe, okay? So I step, brush, nice and bent, and then I releve up onto that foot. That's one, two, three, and then after taking that third step, I come down and brush with the other foot. Brush, okay? So all together, it looks like this. I step, brush, step, one, two, three, on releve, brush, low again, one, two, three, on releve, brush, step, okay? And so on and so forth until you're done with your waltz step. So doing that, we're going to step onto the right foot and brush, step one, two, three, brush, step one, two, three, brush, step, and little curtsy, bring up the right arm, bring up the left arm, cross, curtsy. Doing that towards you so you can watch. So we step on the right foot, step, brush, one, two, three, brush, one, two, three, brush, step, and curtsy, arms come up, up, cross, finish. Very good, all right. So facing the front, rehearsing it one more time, we go, step, brush, one, two, three, brush, one, two, three, brush, step, curtsy, arm up, up, curtsy, finish. Very good. All right, let's practice that a few times with the music. Here we go, from the top.
Dreams you will lose your heartache. Whatever.
Make sure you don't move your spot. All right, now we're gonna use the same foot only. So all left.
Middle, okay? So it should
then we switch. So going over one more time. Shuffle, ball, change, shuffle, step. All right, let's do it across the floor. So we go. Shuffle, ball, change, shuffle, step. 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 Very good. Turn around. Now we're going to do it without me prompting you, okay? You're just going to go straight across the floor. Follow along. Here we go.
Thank you.
guys so much for joining us for our Princess Ballerina class this week. I hope you had fun, I hope you learned a lot, and I will see you next time.